Welcome to my channel. Today's pattern magic style we're working on is called A Dress with a Gathered Hole. The book says, an interesting look where hole is opened and gathered without changing the silhouette of the garment. The gathers are arranged at a right angle to the seam, forming a radial pattern around the hole. If you want to follow along, you can download a bodice block in PDF or claw format or a claw 3D project file. See the Gumroad link in the video description. If you're interested in claw and 3D prototyping and want to learn more, I have a course for beginners on Udemy you might be interested in. You will find the link to the course in the video description. So let's get started. Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we will be developing this style on page 26 of Pattern Magic Book called Dress with a Gathered Hole. So the first step in this development is to create a dress block from a standard bodice block that we already have. Let's take a look at the instructions. We will begin with the back and then move on to the front. So starting with the center back, we see that the dart is not here and it's a folded back, so unfold. We'll get rid of the back center back dart. Next is shoulder is lowered by 1 centimeter. Next I will draw this armscye level line. Lock them. And here you will see that the armscye has been raised by 0.5 centimeter and also brought in by 0.5 centimeter. So let's take this point and we'll go by x-axis minus 0.5 and y-axis 0.5. Okay, that's done. Next, we'll see that here is a 2 centimeter dart from the vertical line. So we're not sure, I can't remember how much we have here. So let's just straighten this out, right? And then I will create this 2 centimeter dart at the waist side. Two centimeters. Okay. Next, I will lengthen the block to 98 centimeters from this point. To do so, I will probably create a clone. Get rid of these darts. It'll be easier to work with. And then I will extend the block till it's 98 centimeters. I'll change the line length. To 98 centimeters. And then even this out here. Like this. Now we have our rectangular kind of dress. Let's just make sure that it's all I would like to find a hip line. Now you will notice that there is no calculation or any indication how to calculate this hip line level. So what I did here, I just basically measured between the edge of the bodice and the hip line on my avatar. And the distance I got is 23 centimeters from the waist. So what I'll do here is just create my waistline and then offset this by 23 centimeters. And here it is, 23 centimeters. So this is where the hip is on my avatar.
let's just come back to our dots. It says that the first dot here starts at 8 centimeters from this end, so 8 centimeters from the center back. I'll split it and create 8 centimeter point. It's supposed to be 2 centimeters wide, and then 4 centimeters after the start, we got another one which is also 2 centimeters wide. So let's create a dot and place it. Well, I need to place it exactly where I want it, so I'll just create this center of the dot point, and then I will place my dot here. So width 1 centimeter to the left, 1 centimeter to the right. Height we will determine in a minute. Okay, so that looks like a correct dot. Let's mark another one while we add it. Okay, so here's where it will end. What I will do now, I'll just copy paste the start here. Only in 3D you can copy paste a hole in a pattern. So let's take a look. Both of the dots touch the line here, so I will extend them up to this line. Okay, then this dot is 2 centimeters shorter and this one is 3 centimeters shorter. What I'll do, I'll extend them both out to the hip level. And then shorten this. It's a bit reversed, but you know, it's easier to do this way because we can control the dart length easier this way. Here we are. Now we have this really strange narrow dress. Next, we need to calculate the hips here. Hip divide by 4 plus 1. Let's take a look. What we have here in Avatar. Lower hip, which is what we need, this level here. 89 centimeters. 89 divided by 4 plus 1. Plus 1. 23, 25. So we will widen this line. To 23, 25. Okay. Now I want to widen the outline of the block as well. And I'll do that. Good. So now we have a little dress. Next, you will see that it has been widened 10 centimeter level here by 1 centimeter. And then we move it out by 1. And then of course we need to make sure that this line is not broken, so I'll just extend it until it's straight. After this, we need to divide this by 4 and then raise this last quarter and a bit, it looks like 1.5 quarters up, and create a right angle. Four parts, and then somewhere here, I think, I need to raise this to get right angle. It's all eyeballing at the moment. Right, let's get rid of these and just make it smooth. like this. All right, looks neat. So what do we have is our back with the darts. Let's see what we have there with the stray sewing. The darts have been sewn. Let's take a look here. Well, it's a mess at this point. At this time, it is a mess, but it will get better. Next is front. We see that the same thing happened with the umsi. It gone up and inwards by half, 2 centimeters at the waist. This dart is missing. You see that this one is not here. So first thing I'll do is create umsi level line. Okay, now I will connect these two parts together. Good. So this dart is gone. This one will be cleaned. Good. Next thing we'll be doing this 2 centimeter waist dart. And now we'll deal with this point. Point 5 X and 0.5 Y. Next, I will need to extend this block to create a dress block. I'll create a clone. And it says here that the length from the waist down is the same as in the back. So we'll measure this length is 60.03. Offset pattern outline. Like this. Okay, now that got me thinking that this possibly is not 2 centimeter dart here anymore. Let me see. That's how it's supposed to be. All right, so the waist, the hip level is 23 centimeters. Okay, at point. And here is hips divided by 4 plus 3. So hips were 89 divided by 4. And plus 3, 25, 25. Make it straight. And same with the flare, 10 centimeters below. Next thing is the dart, of course. The dart is located, I think it's in the original spot. It's 1.5 centimeters wide. So we can create our dart. Let's do it. So 0.75 each side. Okay. 2 centimeters shorter than this level here. I will just unlock internal lines. And I'll extend this to the line. and it doesn't reach 5 centimeters away from the hip line. Get it here. 5. All right, I think it's ready. The reference. And now I'll create one front and one back. Now we have the front and the back. Okay. So this is what we have created. A little basic dress. And next step is to develop the actual model. Right, so now we have front and the back, we can continue developing the model. You see that at the end of this process, we should get this dress with a massive hole in the side. So let's start with the front. You see that because it's an asymmetric dress, we need to get rid of the linked editing in the front and the back. And we will be concentrating on the front. So I'll just put this out there. So here we have a 10 centimeter circular cut. Let's create that. Radius of 10 centimeters. Like this. Okay, and now we can cut it out. Next thing is to clean up this front to make sure that we can actually work with it. That means getting rid of the holes and removing all the lines we will not need. So I will convert the front darts to internal shapes. I will get rid of this bust level and probably this line as well. So we need to have it as clean as possible. Hip level. Next, I will mark all the points where we need to place this raise the cuts. So you see that here it says 4 centimeter segment. So I will split this 4 centimeters and then even cuts, even distances, 1, 2, 3, and 4. After this, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 even segments on this side. These points are done. Next, this cut goes to this point, 5 centimeters from the center front. Shoulder bust point, 9 centimeters above the waist. Then hip point, 18 centimeters from hem. And 12 centimeters on both sides from center front. Okay, now we can begin. So Bunker here says that if our darts get intersected with the line, we can shorten it or lengthen it to make sure that they end at the cut line. So this is what I will be doing. First, this line is in 5 centimeter midpoint. This one goes on like 1/3 of the shoulder. Somewhere here. This line seems to be parallel to this one and it goes to the bust point. So I'll just do that. So this is the three lines. Next goes to the bust point. To the 9 centimeter above the waist, at the waist, then hip 18 centimeters, 12. Hip 18, 12, and 12. All right. So the prep is done. Now I will have to go around and shorten or lengthen these darts to make sure that they touch the cut lines. As you see here, it goes to the bust point, for example. So I'll extend this to the bust point. This one we need to shorten to make it finish here. Next one is here. And it ends at this line, and I think it's good. Next is cutting. I will cut the dress in every line where there's a dart that has to be closed, and these ones I will leave uncut, and I will show you why. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Cut. You see there's some darts here don't want to be cut. You see the one leg disappears. So we'll need to fix that before we move on. What I'll do, move these down, move this just a little bit lower. And I will draw another leg here. Great. So now we have all these pattern pieces we will need to spread. First, to make sure that I can actually recognize which part is where, I will make them all different colors. And now let's see what we need to do. So it says here that we need to open it by 6, 6, 6, 3, 6, 6, 6, 6 centimeters. Some of the darts are not specified because they will be opening by the amount that's controlled by the dart here. So as you can see on the reference, we need to open all these pattern pieces. And here are the widths we have to open them by. Some pattern pieces will be easy to open. We have a specific tool for that. And that's it. That's how easy it is. The rest will be much harder because we need to first of all cut out those darts and then close the pattern pieces and then spread them out by a certain amount. So let's just separate them a little bit like this. there will be a lot of clicking and a lot of merging. So hopefully I will not get an RSI by the end of it. So these are the dots closed here. These ones will need to be cut out. So what I'll do, I will lock pattern outlines and then I'll cut them all at once. Now I'll have to delete these little triangles. And now we need to merge them again. All merged. Next part is spreading all these pattern pieces by a certain amount. So we have done 6 and 6 here, and you see that all we have is 3 and 6. So I will create myself a little jig. So radius will be 6 centimeters. Then I will make it half. And then I will create another line inside. 3 centimeters in. And this will help me to spread these pattern pieces because there's really no tool to do it precisely. So here's my method. I will first of all put this together. And then I will need to rotate this pattern piece so the distance between these two points is 6 centimeters. So first I'll take my little tool. Yeah, one more thing. I need to point at the in the middle of this pattern piece. I will align this with a point. Then I'll take this, move my center of rotation, and then open it by 6 centimeters. Next step, exactly the same. Then we need to close the bus dart, and that will open some distance. So we don't know how wide that distance is. So that's easy enough. We have our bus dart leg here and here. And when we merge it, you see that it opens up that distance here. Next is 6 centimeters again. Like this. Now we have our front pattern piece. Our next step is to create one pattern piece from all these small little parts. One way to do that is to merge the pattern pieces, but for that we need to bring the points together. As you can see, the most important part is this distance here. So we can easily just pull these points together and will preserve the outline of the pattern. Just like that. This can be just deleted. So as long as we get two lines that can be merged, we can merge the pattern pieces. That will be equivalent of putting a little piece of paper underneath and gluing it in a spot, just like in traditional pattern making. And now we can separate these pattern pieces and then merge in each of these lines, and that will keep this outline of the pattern. Great. Next, we'll get rid of all these points here because we need just one solid line. And this line I will smooth out, so I'll create a clone. Then I will get rid of all the points and create nice smooth shape. Okay, and maybe here as well. Great, so all these small lines, blue lines, we can delete. Front is ready, next step is the back. So with the back, you see that there's a similar kind of situation happening here, but this circle cutout is smaller, the smaller part of the circle, and of course it's distributed slightly differently. So I'll just move this part here so we can see what we're doing, and let's begin. So just like with the front, we need to make sure that we have no lines that will be in the way. I'll local pattern outlines and get rid of all this internal line, and here too, and all these dots will be internal shapes. Great. Let me switch to the normal view for now. Okay. So first thing I will do is cut out this circular pattern piece. I'll take my internal ellipse, and it's 10 centimeters. And you see that it touches the dart here. This is what I will do too. I will move it this way, so it touches the leg of the dart. Now we cut it and remove it. This part is done. Next is marking all the points. So we'll just continue with this circle here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal segments on top, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at the bottom. Great, that part is done. Now to the points. 10 centimeters in the arm size. 10. 2 centimeters to the right from center back. 2. 9 centimeters above the waist. 18 here, 13 centimeters to the right, 13, and 7 to the left, 7. That's it. Now we can draw the lines. First here, it looks like it's been cut off. So to the center back here. It looks like the dart will have to be shortened to fit into this pattern piece. Next, to 2 centimeter point, then touching this dart point, shoulder dart point, and past, so here somewhere. Hmm. right? Next is about 1/3 of the arm side. Somewhere here, maybe? I think it, hold on. Next touches the start point. That's what I will do. Sort of like that. Okay. Then 9 centimeter point. The hip line, or the waist, the hip line, the 18 centimeter point, then 13 and 7. Like this. Great. Next, we have to shorten or lengthen all the darts, so the points of the darts end at the cutting lines. So next part is cutting. So just like last time, I will not cut through this line because we can just open it with a tool. All others, unfortunately, will need to be cut. Cut. I will spread this pattern piece by 6 centimeters. That's the easy part. It's done and dusted. We can move that away. Next. This pattern piece here, we need to close the shoulder dart, and then this pattern piece is merged to the front. As you see, it's right here, so we can just do that into this pattern, this shoulder right here. Merge. Here it is. All right, so they're all done. Let's get rid of the pieces. Right, merging. Create the pattern pieces. All the pattern pieces have been merged. Now we need to spread them. This is the pattern piece. Now we need to merge the patterns. And now we can merge the pattern pieces into one. Like this. I will get rid of this line. And this is the back. Okay, so here we are. Let's get rid of the baselines and reference points. I mean, and the clown. Okay. We have a front and the back. Let's rotate it in place. Great. And let's see what's happening here. First of all, we need to figure out our sewing. Let's take a look. We forgot to sew this one. No. Good. Our little floating pattern piece can be deleted. Here's what we have. Huge hole. Let's make it a dress. So what we can do here is take these long seams and gather them up. It looks pretty nice. So here is our asymmetric dress called Dress with a Gathered Hole. I hope you enjoyed the process. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.